be with you.
With your spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith: Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it: Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord, Heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, the protector of all that trust in thee, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy, increase and multiply upon us thy mercy, that thou, being our ruler and guide, we may so pass through things temporal that we finally lose not the things eternal. Grant this, O Heavenly Father, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost art one God, world without end.
Amen. The epistle is written in the 8th chapter of Romans, beginning at the 18th verse. I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. For the earnest expectation of the creature waiteth for the manifestation of the sons of God. For the creature was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who hath subjected the same in hope. Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. For we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain together until now. And not only they, but ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit, even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption, to wit, the redemption of our body. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the sixth chapter of the Gospel according to St. Luke, beginning at the 36th verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Be ye therefore merciful, as your Father also is merciful. Judge not, and ye shall not be judged. Condemn not, and ye shall not be condemned. Forgive, and ye shall be forgiven. Give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, and shaken together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom. For with the same measure that ye meet withal, it shall be measured to you again." And he spake a parable unto them. Can the blind lead the blind? Shall they not both fall into the ditch? The disciple is not above his master, but every one that is perfect shall be as his master. And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but perceivest not the beam that is in thine own eye? Either, how canst thou say to thy brother, "Brother, let me pull out the mote that is in thine eye," when thou thyself beholdest not the beam that is in thine own eye? Thou hypocrite, cast out first the beam out of thine own eye, and then thou shalt see clearly to pull out the mote that is in thy brother's eye.
Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and is at the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeded from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Please be seated. Jesus said, "Be ye therefore merciful, as your Father also is merciful." It is important to note at the outset that today's gospel lesson comes from the first extended discourse by Jesus, as recorded in St. Luke's gospel. Known as the Sermon on the Plain, this discourse bears a striking similarity to the Sermon on the Mount, which appears early in St. Matthew's gospel. Whether these are the same or different sermons is not as important, as that both sermons represent Jesus' first extended teaching on moral and ethical issues. Luke tells us that just before delivering the Sermon on the Plain, Jesus spent all night in prayer. And immediately afterward, he selected 12 apostles from a larger group of disciples. Clearly, Jesus had something important to say, and he wanted to make sure his newly appointed apostles and other followers heard it. The sermon is not long, only 29 verses, and it only takes about 5 minutes to read out loud. It's in Luke 6, verses 20 through 49. I recommend that you do so in order to put today's gospel reading into context and to appreciate the impact the sermon must have had on its astonished hearers. Interestingly, the passage I quoted earlier, "Be ye merciful as your Father also is merciful," comes right in the middle of the sermon. And I do not think this is an accident, because I believe it serves as the central theme of the sermon. But why did Jesus choose mercy as the theme for his first extended sermon? I think the answer is found in the fact that Jesus was God, and his first sermon to his apostles and to the public at large should accurately reflect God's fundamental character. That character was first revealed by God in vivid fashion to Moses. As told in Exodus chapter 34, God was about to provide Moses with a replacement set of the Ten Commandments after Moses had destroyed the first set in a rage after finding Aaron and the Israelites worshiping the golden calf. The Exodus account tells us that the Lord descended in the cloud and stood with Moses there and proclaimed the name of the Lord. The Lord passed before him and proclaimed, the Lord, a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness, keeping steadfast love for thousands, forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin. Exodus 34, verses 6 and 7. This astounding revelation by God of his name and character is so fundamentally important that it appears in various forms as a central theme all throughout the books of the Old Testament, in passages too numerous to quote. And the word mercy, along with its variants such as mercies and merciful, appears over 270 times in the Old Testament and 65 times in the New Testament, mostly in context describing God's character or invoking his undeserved mercy. It is little wonder, then, that Jesus selected mercy as the central theme of his first extended discourse to the public. Providentially, our bishop spoke last week about humility being the gateway to receiving God's mercy. This week's gospel shows us the path we must walk to extend mercy to our neighbors. But what is mercy, and how do we practice it? Merriam-Webster's dictionary defines mercy as compassion or forbearance shown especially to an offender or to one subject to one's power. That is a good basic definition, but Jesus did not give us an academic definition of mercy in his sermon. He gave us a very specific and practical roadmap for practicing mercy. In the verses just before today's gospel reading, Jesus starts off with a commandment which, for many of us, is the most difficult of all. Love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who abuse you. Luke 6:27 and 28. It is hard to imagine just how revolutionary this commandment must have seemed to Jesus' audience, and it remains no less revolutionary and challenging for us. It goes against our very nature to do these things, doesn't it? The commandments which follow in today's gospel reading further illustrate mercy in action. Judge not, condemn not, forgive, and give generously. Observed faithfully, these qualities enable us to be merciful just as God is merciful, just as he described himself to Moses, and just as Jesus modeled perfectly during his life. Of course, this is easier said than done, and sometimes Jesus' commandments are twisted into meanings he never intended. For example, his admonitions not to judge or condemn are too often used as excuses to justify or overlook sinful behaviors that are clearly contrary to Scripture and the orthodox teaching of the church. What Jesus is really warning about is adopting an attitude that judges or condemns sin in others while ignoring the same or worse sins in ourselves. He is not asking us to abandon the obligation of exercising godly discernment and discipline. Like the Ten Commandments, these essential qualities of mercy are not mere suggestions. They are expected to be ever more present in every believer. Already this morning, we have invoked God's mercy three times in the Kyrie. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. And twice in the Gloria. O Lord God, Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. In a few minutes, we will invoke God's mercy again in the confession. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. And in the Agnus Dei, O Lamb of God that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. That is a lot of mercy seeking. Happily for us, in the absolution following the confession, God, acting through the priest, graciously extends that mercy to, quote, all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, unquote. Yet in his Sermon on the Plain, Jesus commands us to be just as diligent in extending mercy to others as we are in seeking God's mercy. So, as we prepare to receive the Holy Eucharist, let us carefully examine ourselves and pray for grace to discern and confess how we might have fallen short of this holy standard in the past, and pray also for the grace and the humility to walk ever more faithfully on the path of mercy that Jesus has set before us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
All things come of thee, O Lord.
Amen.
We offer this holy sacrifice for the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and giving God thanks this day and always for his unbelievable mercy in our lives. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
The Lord receives the sacrifice of thy hands, to the praise of the Lord and his name, both to our benefit and at all to the church.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who to confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against the divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul said, "This is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners." Hear also what St. John saith, "If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins." The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty, everlasting God, for the precious death and merits of thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and for the sending to us of the Holy Ghost, the Comforter, who are one with thee in thy everlasting Godhead. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify, with thy word and Holy Spirit, these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. Let us pray now as our Savior Christ hath taught us. We are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils, past, present, and to come. And at the intercession of all thy saints, grant peace favorably in our day, that we, being holpen by the succor of thy mercy, may be both free from sin and safe from all disquietude, through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be alway with you.
And with
us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace. O Lord Jesus Christ, who says to thine apostles, Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Regard not my sins, but the faith of thy church, and grant to it that peace and unity which is according to thy will, who livest and reignest God, world without end. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us.
Amen.
Let me see the bread of heaven, I call upon the name of the Lord, and it's my strength and my salvation. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that taketh away the sins of the world. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee. Preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. Amen. Body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee. Preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be upon you this day and always. Amen. Come with us, O blessed Jesus, with us evermore to be. And in leaving now thine altar, let us nevermore leave thee. O let thine angel chorus cease not the heavenly strain, but in us, thy loving children, bring peace. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries, with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With thy spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men, and the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born, not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world seeking the ruin of souls. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Praised, blessed, and adored be our Lord Jesus Christ on his most glorious throne in heaven. in the most holy sacrament of the altar, and in the hearts of his faith-filled people. May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. We thank you for finding us at St. Luke's here this day. We do this every single week, so if you can't make it to your church, consider yourself an internet member of St. Luke's Church. Also, invite your friends.